Hello guys, welcome back with me, Chow Chow 2025. Today we're gonna learn how to have a local private chat GPT slash bard in your own local computer. Not only for answering questions, but we could also role play and pretend to have a relationship with the AI. We could use this oobabooga text generation webui. This powerful tool is about to unlock a whole new level of creativity. So get ready to harness the power of AI for your writing projects. Oobabooga text generation webui lets you generate unique and engaging text content with just a few clicks. Imagine writing stories, poems, scripts, marketing copy, or even emails with the help of AI. Sounds pretty awesome, right? Before we jump into the installation, let's make sure you have everything you need. Here's a quick checklist of prerequisites. First, you need to have Python and Git. Link on description on how to install Python and Git, or simply check the playlist. You also need GPU with at least 6 gigs of VRAM. 8 gigs is recommended. Higher is better. Try using my GTX 1660 Super. It is working, but the reaction is too slow, so it is not a very fun experience. After you get all that, access the library at github.com/oobabooga/text-generation-webui. Simply clone this library by accessing folder where you want to download and call CMD there. Later, you simply copy paste this code and write git clone the link. After you clone it, you can now set it up for the first time by double clicking start in windows.bat in text generation web UI folder. When asked your GPU, select what you have. Since I use RTX 4060 Ti here, I select NVIDIA. And I also use the newest CUDA since I use RTX. It will not start downloading a few large files, so we'll skip the video. Fast forward. After everything is finished, you will be warned that you have not downloaded any model and it will recommend that you download one. Also, the startup, only this long for the first time only. After this, everything is going to be so much faster. You will then inform the link. You can now access text generation webui using the link provided. As you can see in model tab, we don't have any model yet. We need to download one first. So let's access Hugging Face first. In Hugging Face, let's search GPT. Click Show All Result in Model section. Filter it to text generation only. Since the book has many models, I access his profile and try to download one of his most downloaded models that is Vicuna Uncensored. To download the model, simply copy the Hugging Face username and model, and then go back to text generation web UI. From model tab, put the username SLA model name to text box download model in LoRa, and then click download. The model gonna be downloaded in the background. Just check the CMD for more detail. It's 4.5 gigs, so it's gonna take a while. While we wait, let's go back to huggingface.co. You can see that each model has number of how many data it was trained, like 7 billion, 13 billion, or more. The more big the training data is, the more VRAM you're going to use. So make sure to not download something that your system couldn't handle. The size of the model also going to follow the size of the data it was trained to. The more data you use, the larger the size of the model will be. You could also check which branch that you want to use by checking GPTQ parameter. Bits is the bit size of the Qantas model. GS is GPTQ group size. Higher numbers use less VRAM but have lower quantization accuracy. None is the lowest possible value. ACT order true or false, also known as disconnect. True results in better quantization accuracy. Some GPTQQ clients have had issues with models that use ACT order plus group size, but this is generally resolved now. Damp percentage is a GPTQ parameter that affects how samples are processed for quantization. 0.0.1 is default, but but 0.1 results in slightly better accuracy. GPTQ dataset is the dataset used for quantization. Using a dataset more appropriate to the model's training can improve quantization accuracy. Note that the GPTQ dataset is not the same as the dataset used to train the model. Sequence length is the length of the dataset sequences used for quantization. Ideally, this is the same as the model sequence length. For some very long sequence models like 16 plus K, a lower sequence length may have to be used. Note that a lower sequence length does not limit the sequence length. XL Llama compatibility decide whether this file can be loaded with XL Llama, which currently only supports L Llama models in 4-byte. Here, the list of the branch. If you want to download a branch, just add the branch after the model name separate with colon symbol. Okay, the model is downloaded. Time to use it. Refresh it and then select the model from the drop-down list. It will auto-load the setting, refer to the document, how to use the model. Since we use the main branch, the info said that it used 4 bits and used 2048 sequence length for loader. Since it decided to use the XLL2HS, we're going to use the XLL loader. It seems everything already set up when we click the model, so just click load. Check the CMD to make sure the model already loaded, and then click chat. Remember, this is the basic chat without me giving any personality to the model. And here's some demonstration. I will fast forward this. Feel free to pause and read it yourself. Okay, that is a little demonstration with this 7 billion training data. I get each respond instantly. I use RTX 4060 Ti 16 gigs. According to what model you download, they could be stupid, so don't rely on them for information. Each model has its own purpose. Some model was created for role playing, some was created for adult entertainment, and some actually created to be like Bard and ChatGPT. Make sure you read the description of the model and the review if there's any. Anyways, guys, there's so much more to the text generation web UI to be learned. But for now, let's stop here. We're going to have many text generation web UI video in the future, including how to have a good role play with AI that have personality that you could custom. That is, thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and comment. See you again on the next episode. Have a nice day. Please subscribe.